The Beach Boys.
Should I tell the truth?
51 with highlights of today's rain-delayed trophy final between Northamptonshire and Warwickshire. Introduced by Tony Lewis.
Welcome to Lords, the last big cricket match of the summer, the NatWest final, Warwickshire against Northamptonshire, and a big crowd, of course, building up. Unfortunately, we had rain all the morning, but then, as if by miracle, the clouds parted, the sun came out, and now, towards 3 o'clock in the afternoon, we're expecting play. Two sides very much in form. Warwickshire, this is their third successive appearance in a NatWest final. They lost to Worcestershire last year, but achieved very much with the great batting of Brian Lara. This time it's Alan Donald, the explosive fast bowler from South Africa, who's bringing them to the title stage again. As for North Ants, well, they won the title twice here, and the explosive captaincy of Alan Lamb has to be a real consideration as we work out the equations, and also the mystifying spin of Anil Kumble. A short while ago, I was on the middle with the captains for the toss. Sound like good news to you, Alan?
Yeah, the wicket looks fairly dry. Looks a good wicket, and we've decided to have a bat.
How do you view the split of the innings now? Because probably just one inning's available today.
That was one of the reasons. I didn't want to bat in the dark, facing Donald in the dark. Better to catch him in a bit of sunshine.
And what about batting in the morning? Because this has a history of things going wrong in the morning.
Yeah, but it's fairly dry, this wicket. I don't think overnight's going to do anything. You know, the wicket's been, you know, well covered and that, so it should remain a good wicket.
How does your team look?
We've got the same side as the semi-final, so there's no changes.
How's your own form?
Well, I've been hitting them all right. I hope I hit them even better this game.
And is Ray Illingworth speaking to you?
I don't know. I think he lost my phone number.
Good luck, Lammy.
Cheers.
Dermot, the toss, is that why you were losing the toss?
No, not really. I didn't really mind which way we'd done it. In fact, I'd probably been tempted to have a bowl then.
Now, you have had some injury problems. Tell us about those.
Yeah, we've had a couple of breaks to a couple of the players, Nick Knight's finger, which made him miss the Oval Test match, and Dougie Brown actually broke his hand in the last match at Gloucester. But they'll both play, even with slight cracks. They're both past fit. But the bad news for us is Tim Munton, who has done such a sterling job for us, particularly in the quarter-final and semi-final. He's done a rib injury, which they can be quite serious. So Michael Bell comes in for Tim Munton.
And no Gladstone Small?
No, Gladstone, unfortunately, has had trouble most of the season, and we're also missing Andy Moles. So we've got a couple of our real experienced guns out. But the youngsters that have been coming in this season have been doing very well.
It does seem to me, Dermot, that you're quite used to playing here. Your third successive final here. You lost last year, won the year before. Do you feel it's within the team they expect to win?
Well, I think the boys always expect to win. They're a confident bunch of lads with a lot of self-belief. But in the end of the day, it doesn't really matter whether you've won or lost, Tony. It's just that they've done their best. And we always instill that to them and concentrate on taking it one day at a time. But it is a bit of a second home to some of the boys now. Some of the fellas are only in their mid-20s and they're playing in their third or fourth Lord's final, so they've got that experience on their side, which hopefully will help.
And finally, you yourself seem to love it here.
Yeah, I do love it here. I started my career here as an MTC young cricketer when I was 18 and used to work the scoreboards and sell scorecards, but it's much better playing out in the middle, but it is my favourite ground.
I wish you luck.
Thanks, Tony.
But now here's Geoffrey Boycott with a pitch report.
Well, after all the rain this morning, you can't believe how nice it is and how dry the pitch is. If we have a look here, you can see how dry it is. I rub my hand on it. There's nothing. There's no green grass at all. There's no dampness. And it's that dry, which is all credit to the ground staff and the groundsman. All cracks. This pitch will only bounce about stump high. It won't be very quick. They're not quick at Lords anymore. They're going to dig some of them up, so it'll be just pleasant, true for batting. And I'm not surprised that Alan Lamb wants to bat in it, get the opportunity, get in first. The sun's out. It's just right, and I can't see the fast bowlers getting too much movement out of the pitch or any real bounce or pace.
Well, North Ants have the exuberant captaincy of Alan Lamb in there, and he's a constant inspiration to them. And also those two forthright all-rounders, Kevin Curran and David Capel, they'll be expected to play an important part. And Warwickshire have Nick Knight back, that's important. And Dermot Reeve, of course, the inventive captain, something of a mysterious man in this sort of cricket, always seems to come out on top. Umpires Harold Bird and Mervyn Kitchen, third umpire Roy Palmer. North Ants, winning the toss, are batting first. Let's join them now, the last ball of the second over. Brown bowls to Fordham, no runs scored.
Nicely bowled. Good first over.
Yes, Dougie Brown just running it down the hill. Just holds its line. It doesn't have to do anything. He just holds its line down that slope. North Ants usually have a game plan. Their openers try to get good, solid start and try not to lose wickets. They prefer to bat first. And then they have a big acceleration in the middle of the innings because they've got all those stroke players.
Appealed for that, but getting nothing.
Yes, and that's only the second ball. He's really pitched up, Alan Donald. I mentioned this pitch doesn't have a lot of bounce or pace in it. I think he can afford to pitch it right up like this. See, that hitting the batsman's pad round about just below the knee roll. Not going to get too much pace out of the pitch, so if he can get it up there a little bit more. Most opening batsmen are looking to get on the back foot to fast bowlers. And that was a beauty. Drew the batsman forward. That's the sort of length. An absolute peach. It left him off the deck, went up the slope a little bit. One of those balls that you think as a bowler you deserve a wicket for that.
He's done him again. Doing a lot, but it's just in that area outside off stump that isn't quite wide enough to satisfy the batsman. He can leave it just to... Bowling. First strike, and Richard Montgomery goes, and Alan Donald has struck. 4 for 1.
Well, I mentioned about getting the batsman on the front foot, and that's what he did. He pitched it up, he got Montgomery forward, lovely length. It did nip back down the slope. You'll see it nip back quite a lot. He pushed through the ball, wasn't the best of shots, but the bowler did everything right.
New batsman Rob Bailey. Great shot, first boundary.
Yes, a nice juicy half volley, a little bit wide as well.
So close to a second wicket.
Well, a great opportunity here that was missed. He pitched it up again. Didn't quite get forward. Nicked it, but I'm not sure it carried, actually. I think the keeper was the one that might have got to it, but it never really quite got to first slip. Not but just if it did.
Just away from second slip and for four runs.
Was always going down, it bounced just in front of Reeve. He'd moved that second slip away to something round about fourth or fifth. He's now brought him back again.
There's a penny, the fielder. Penny is a very good fielder. Just got himself a fraction off balance there. There must be a signal between Donald and the wicketkeeper and slips, because this is what they did. Donald was within 3 or 4 yards and up they came. They came 5 or 6 yards forward. So they must have known about it, and it must have been something Donald did in his run-up. They didn't march up straight away. They waited until he was 5 or 6 yards from the bowling crease. A nice stroke, good timing, and lovely placement. Neil Smith, the off-spinner, has the man out at mid-off. Alan Donald has given that flick away to Penny. A great pleasure in that. It was a good stroke from the batsman, and not totally appreciated by the bowler. Bailey's in good touch.
Yeah, he's a big strong man, Rob Bailey, and uses a pretty heavy bat too, and there was enough width outside the off stump. A lot of wrist in this shot too, a lot of forearm, a lot of wrist. Do get the odd risk with Alan Fordham. Very keen to put bat on ball, a very fierce striker of a cricket ball when in full flow. Played over the top of that one.
That's it. That's all we're saving. Inside edge, back onto the stumps. Alan Fordham goes. Just when North Hants were getting things going again after the early setback of losing Montgomery, they've now lost Fordham, and it's 39 for 2. Bowled by Brown for 20 from just 30 balls faced.
Well, he was better off playing over the top of it. He got close to this one, which was the fatal error. And a very thick bottom edge drags it back onto the stump, so every batsman always feels that's an unfortunate way to go. Picks out the middle stump as well. But he's an important man for Northants to lose there. He's been in such good form in this competition. He's scored a lot of runs in the build-up to this final. He's a man who knows how to go about building a big innings in one-day cricket. And if Warwick should continue chipping away, taking wickets like this at regular intervals, then that's going to stymie the Northants innings. Alan Lamb, the new batsman, Northants captain, he's having a great season. Enjoying the responsibility of captaining and, in effect, managing the side this year. He's led them to within the striking zone, as it were, at the top of the county championship table. He's led them to this NatWest final. And he's here because of this. Wide of off stump, enticing the shot. But the execution not quite good enough by Alan Fordham.
It was such a thick edge that it actually hit the ground rather than just coming back onto the stumps. It's hit the ground, bounced up, and then found the stumps. Just under 2,000 runs for Alan Lamb in this competition.
Not a pretty sight this for Northants supporters. A very free shot from Alan Lamb just from the second ball he's received. Trying to drive it away on the up. Saving grace was that back leg that got in the way of this inside edge.
Alan Lamb wasn't content with the slightly loose stroke he played the ball before, but he flashed at that one, and Dougie Brown has him for naught, caught by Dominic Ostler at slip. And that is a crushing blow for Northamptonshire.
That's a really important wicket for Warwickshire. Standard delivery from Dougie Brown. It's just nipped away a bit. He's bowled a few of those today. And the great thing for Dominic Ostler, he was in exactly the right position. He's the lone slip, but he's stood wide. Quite often happens that when there's just one slip there in one day cricket, he goes that bit wider. A lovely comfortable catch for him. No wonder he was delighted. But a big disappointment for Northamptonshire, a huge disappointment for their captain. He was in very relaxed form speaking to Tony Lewis before the match, saying how well he felt. But this is a loose shot, make no bones about that. Wide of off stump, the hands were a long way from the body. Just at a time when Northants really wanted their captain to play himself in, assess the state of the game for the next few overs, and then perhaps play one of his great knocks. It's all over in a hurry.
Only just had time to say good afternoon. 39 for three they are now. Been plenty of rain here. The uphill is still fairly quick. It rained throughout the night and then it delayed play until 3 o'clock. And it's wet enough that the field is spikes. We'll dig up the ground a little out there towards the boundary.
Gary Lineker, there is an MCC member. Amongst anything else, he's done his qualifying matches for the MCC over the last few seasons. Played what matches he could in the summer holidays.
That was a decidedly quick delivery from Michael Bell. Gone all along the ground from pretty much the cue end of the bat. Got away with it. Second slip, it might have been something.
Well, if it had been something, it didn't deserve it, the ball. It's almost full toss wide. He goes after it, Rob Bailey, but he just gets a sort of outside top edge. He got four runs, but that wasn't the way he was looking for.
It's nicely played. Controlled shot, placed well.
Yes, they need one or two shots like this. K carefully, nicely played. They don't need anything too ambitious at the moment. They need orthodox cricket shots. They're scoring all right at 3 runs and over.
Big appeal. Huge appeal.
Well, it was a funny sort of shuffling shot. It was nothing really. Just really played across his pad. You'll see him here, he plays, puts his foot on the line, then he can't get at the ball.
We're in the 24th over of the innings, so this is just a matter of ticking over for a few overs for this pair. Warwickshire can nick another wicket, and that was nearly one. And they'll feel that they have a big advantage.
Yes, this ball just kept flowing and bounced twice to the keeper. Normally, facing Dermot Reeve, it's not anything particular he does. It's just that he mixes up everything. That's his style, very definitely. If he can't play the nudging and pushing of ones and twos, he might as well resort to his normal game. Might as well get out or get runs, take the game away from Warwickshire. This is how he normally plays. He goes the aerial route here, and a lot of his shots are simply that. Over the top of fielders, he hits it hard. He's a clean striker of the ball.
Another single. Brings up the 50 partnership, the end of the 30th over, 89 for 3, Northampton recovering slowly.
Oh!
There's a lowish bounce. There's that one there. Rob Bailey stayed back and it went about halfway up his back. It would have hit the back, look. A knee roll probably there. He was halfway up the bat and hit about the knee roll.
Yeah!
It's out. Down the slow loop. Thrash off the back foot. Inside edge. Wicket that's gone down. Off an inside edge. You can't believe it, Rob Bailey. But I was just talking about the pitch, how low a bounce it has. He throws it up. Real nice big loop. Throws it outside off stump. Turns a little. He thrashes at it, but it doesn't bounce much, that's the thing.
Well, that's the most important wicket. Rob Bailey goes to 44. He is the man in form, 89 for 4 in the 31st over.
This was mentioning about this pitch. It is a good pitch for batting. It's not necessarily a good quick scoring pitch. There's a difference. That's what we found in the test match, which England won against West Indies. You can bat on it. Good pitch, not so easily to get out. But it's not so easy to score quickly, as the Northants batsmen have found.
David Capel is the new batsman. Just to back up that statement by Geoffrey Boycott, two batsmen now have chopped the ball onto the wickets, trying to play a shot square on the offside. That's a sure indication that the pitch is not as quick as they think it is. Big shout there from Dermot Reeve.
Well, all these worth shouting for. And you can rest assured that Warwickshire will be up every time the pad is struck like that.
Runs coming fine down the leg side. Three runs, leg byes.
I tell you from previous experience that sun does get very low and nastily placed over the pavilion as this afternoon wears on.
back down the pitch by Kevin Curran might well have been a bit of an eye test for Dickie Bird. Typical Curran, this.
He's really worked hard to get the right hand into the shot. It's a clubbed shot, a lot of bottom hand in it. This is right up Dermot Reeves Street, this inside edge onto the thigh. Well, he seems to make something happen, does Dermot Reeve. At least as far as David Cable was concerned, the pace taken off the ball, so Keith Piper unable to get up there.
Yes, one jump.
A little bit of sympathy for Brown there, because he has a broken finger out there. That's in the air. It's a beautiful shot. Six runs. Really hear the crack of that.
This is right out of the screws, as they say in Australia, and went on to the balcony of the grandstand. There's a fellow up there in a grey t-shirt, made actually quite a good effort to catch it.
Brilliant. Trevor Penny in his usual position, just backward of square on the offside.
Yeah, good stuff. Hit firmly into the ground first. Very quick to react. Nicely balanced, Trevor Penny.
Oh, yes. Cable walks. Beautiful catch by the keeper.
Well, he only just carries through. Keith Piper actually anticipated. He came forward just a little bit. He picked up the trajectory very quickly. Very good sign in a keeper. But David Capel out for 12. It was one of those shots that you feel is on. And then it turns out you're not quite there, which he wasn't with the left foot. It turns out to be a mistake. And Dermot Reeve has done it again.
And the incoming batsman, Russell Warren.
Well, he's coming to the crease with Northants in some trouble, 110 for 5.
Oh, that ran backwards. The eyes is scarcely bear to watch it there.
Well, Russell Warren didn't seem to be aware at all what was happening. He just played a dead bat on it.
Get it! Get it! Get it!
Wait, wait, they say. And that's the style of Trevor Penny, which surprises so many players.
You can't afford to lapse for just a moment with Trevor Penny around. Very quick onto the ball again.
It's nicely played, clearing the man at short cover and beating the man at long off. That's cleverly placed by Kevin Curran.
He's very good, Kevin Curran, at playing these sort of into-out shots. He's very strong on the offside. It wasn't a long way from Roger Tews at extra cover there. Probably about 3 yards to his right. But the ball was hit with such pace that he had no chance to make any ground towards it.
Well, they'll take the maximum for that. Might have been thick edge, but North Hants will grab anything at the moment.
Well, boundaries haven't exactly been flowing, and the edge often the most effective way of finding the boundary in one-day cricket.
Not much doubt about that. Defeated him for pace, and that has made things extremely difficult now for Northamptonshire. Curran out bowled by Donald for 30 from 80 balls gives you an idea of the pressure that's been put on North Hants at the moment.
Well, it's a great demonstration of what a great fast bowler can do for you. Speared in, it's come off the pads. It was probably missing leg stump until it deflected off the pads, but Kevin Curran playing across the ball. It's always a pretty good thing to have in mind that when you're playing against someone of Alan Donald's pace, the more you can keep the face of the bat coming back towards the ball, the better it's likely to be. Tony Bembathy is the new batsman, left-handed batsman, all-rounder. Alan Donald's figures, 8 overs, 1 maiden, 2 now for 24.
128 for 6. And the skipper out for naught. That's not going to be something that will please the skipper very much. Straightforward loosener from Paul Smith. And a straightforward miss by Keith Piper. Cricket from Dermot Reeve. Just got him on that very painful bit just up above the hand. Deep in wicket, but he's got no chance. That's a good shot. Warren has gone on to 16 from the last ball of that over from Paul Smith. It's now 143 for 6. It's got to go. Brings up the 150 and then the 50th, so minimum score of 200. It's a possibility that certainly one, if not both, of this pair have got to do the majority of it. But it's cost a run. No chance of a run out. It was not a great return from Osler. Let's see how it eluded wicketkeeper Piper. That's why, because he didn't get too much behind it and came to very awkward height. Plays that shot well. It's a rare boundary. the sort of batting that has won Russell Warren his place this year. To get him in, he's keeping wicket. He can certainly hit the ball off the back foot. Well, Bell has got the minimum four in the ring. Three offside, one leg side. Oh, took it. Has he got him? Ask for the replay. It's Trevor Penny again. Piper has embraced Penny. He thinks he knows. Kitchen now awaits.
Well, I think it looked tight. It looked more in favour of the fielder. You can never tell till you get the replay. But he does get in quick and then he releases the ball quick. And he does have this uncanny knack of hitting the stumps. Oh, tight, isn't it? Oh, he's gone. I think he's gone, maybe only by an inch or two, but he's just gone. You see, he's not only in quick, he has the ability to pick it up and let go, off balance.
And he's gone. There we are, Tony Penberthy. It was Warren's call and he went, but the man concerned was the last one you try that to. And this is exactly what happened at normal speed that umpire Kitchen had to look at. No wonder he had to call for some assistance. How'd you like that? Nobody could ever have told without recourse to technology. Well, eight overs left now to make something of what at the moment is a very moderate total. And again. Well, sometimes a class fielder has times when the ball follows him, but more often than not, he is in that key, crucial position. Now, that was push and run to try and rotate the strike, but look at that for a left-handed stop. Done him again, stranded if he hits. Well, it's every ball. Trevor Penny's been in the action five out of the last six deliveries.
Yes, and Jeremy Stay, he realises runs are important. He's trying to get young Warren on strike. He's pushing it and he's off running as soon as he makes contact with the middle of the bat. But as you can see, it's just silly running. Bounced over the top, actually.
Good save, but valuable runs have gone back to three. A scramble and chase and drag out every possible run now. Neil Smith was the fielder. He's had a good day so far, bowled well. Good in the field. Pipe out. Beautiful take. Very good effort to get to it. It's just come off the heel, just there. Piper has gone for it and done a great job. Not an easy decision for the umpire either. I think he's fingertipped it. But did he fingertip it over the rope? He's not going to know. Be the last to know. And all the North Hants supporters are claiming six, and all the Warwickshire supporters are saying, don't be so ridiculous. Dickie Bird's asking for television adjudication. beautifully picked up. Paul Smith was the man coming around just got his fingertips stirred. Sorry about this, Harold. Gotta have a word with Merv Kitchen. It's a Dorothy Dix.
Well, that was good. That was right to wait for the third umpire, because in these one-day matches, a couple of runs can make all the difference.
Ten off that over, so it's a good one for Northamptonshire. Not quite so good for Roger Tuse at cover. Was what caused the injury to Roger Tuse, and he's had to race from the field. Now, the reason the umpires have produced light meters, as though by magic, is that Alan Donald is being brought back into the attack. So, umpire Bird at square leg will see how he goes at following the ball right from the hand to the batsman. And then it may be that in this 57th over, the umpires will offer the light. Well, he's got that away fine. It's a question of whether it came off the bat or not. It looked as though it was a bottom edge. And it's been given runs. And now we're into the 190s for Northants. Safely way over point. Good shot. Jeremy Snape has judged that perfectly. It's not at all easy out there at the moment. And the score's gone along now to within 4 of 200.
They're doing exceptionally well, the two late order players. And still the umpires are worried about the light. It looks to me as if they've offered the light to the batsmen, and the batsmen have declined. If they want to finish the innings, only two overs to go, they're warm, they're getting runs. If they're not seeing it too well, they're still hitting it well, and that's all that matters. The score is mounting quite nicely for them.
Gone, caught behind. It says a lot for Piper's eyesight and reflexes that he was able to see it. He's taken a good catch. He had to go down the leg side to get it, so it may show on the replay that it was an inside edge, and quite possibly a fairly thick one. Jeremy Snape caught Piper Bowl Donald 21 from only 28 balls.
Well, Jeremy Snape will feel that it's ironic that they've stayed on once they've been offered Bud Light, and then he's gone and nicked it. This stage of the game, can't blame any player for getting out in any way.
It's just a couple of minutes after 7 o'clock as Anil Kumble comes out, and the light is not good, and that is despite the fact that there is a bit of sunshine away to the north. We're not getting it here at the ground. And now the umpires are having another word. They will check to see how the light is. He's got it written down there what the reading was last time it was taken. Now he'll try it again. And yes, it is offered. And there's a bit of jeering from the crowd. Once they lost the wicket there, with Kumble coming out and not being accustomed to the bad light, his eyes haven't been adjusted, then they're better off to come back tomorrow to start at 10:30.
The removal of Lamb and Montgomery early in the innings, now that was absolutely crucial as far as Warwickshire were concerned, very damaging for Northants. they managed to thread together some partnerships of importance, particularly Bailey and Curran put on 50, and there was some good, sensible, rather than spectacular batting, which built up the effort at the tail. 197 for 8, or 58.3 overs. As for the bowling, well, Donald got his usual early breakthrough and came back and knocked over a couple more. The subtlety of Neil Smith I enjoyed. Off spin, no room for the batsman to play, extravagant shots. And Dermot Reeve, of course, he was full of a mixture of swing and seam, clever variation, 12 overs, 1 for 31. Great fielding, too, by Trevor Penny. Now, there will be highlights tomorrow night at 10 to 1 on BBC Two, but we are back live for the first ball of play when it reaches us tomorrow, 10:30 in the morning on BBC One. The Northants have been talking about a slow pitch which hindered them out there, and they'll be hoping that Warwickshire find exactly the same conditions tomorrow. But we'll be here to find out live from us all at Lord's for the moment. Goodbye.